What's up, Soul Tribe? It's your girl Dominique with Empathic Guidance, and I'm back with another video for you guys today. Today, before I get started, or before we just jump right into this video, I definitely want to give a couple of shout outs. Y'all know I love giving shout outs. I am a true believer in wishing other people success brings you closer to success yourself, because again, what you put out, you get back, right? Okay. So, two new supporters. Well, Jay has been with me for a while, but I definitely want to give him a shout out because he literally always comments on every single video, and I love his videos. He is, definitely, his content is, mukbangs. Or whatever. So that's the brunt of his content. The name of his channel is called Cheat Day with Jay. So Cheat Day with Jay. That is his channel name. He has really interesting mukbangs on there, and he is very consistent. So he has a very gentle, loving spirit that I really enjoy. So, guys, go and join him over there on Cheat Day with Jay, because he is bomb. If you guys wonder what I got in my hand, it's my natural quartz. So, I'm just trying to get the energy flowing, because Sundays are a pretty tired day for me normally, because I begin the last bit of my rest before I get back up and start all over again on Monday. So, other than that, like I said yesterday, guys, when I gave a shout out at the end of my video for the friend that I had on Facebook, that I said, once we start talking, the whole thread just be flowing out in the open. Like, we just connect on that type of level. Well, she ended up dropping the link to her YouTube in my inbox. And her page is incredible, and she doesn't even have any idea how great her page is, how great her channel is. She has great editing skills. She's absolutely gorgeous. Her smile is beautiful. She is just perfect. Like, she is literally perfect. Her content is pretty much vlogs, story times. Just, you know, sharing her life with us, and she's very adequately spoken, as well as her voice is very calming and very soothing. She's very nice to listen to, you guys. And if you are, possess ASMR qualities, I think you would love listening to her talk. And she always has, like, good rhythmic music to kind of go along with her soothing voice. And I love it. I absolutely love it. I am a great big new fan of hers. And, you know, I'm not going to put her Facebook name on there, because maybe that's something she'll share on her channel. And if you go over there, you'll get a chance to be in contact with this wonderful being. And she has me smiling. You see how this is? Like, high vibrational people make me feel like this. And she is very high vibrational, very cute. Like, you guys are going to love her. But the name of her channel is Dipped in Indigo. That is Dipped in Indigo. All one word, no spaces. Go and check her out. Subscribe to her channel. Watch a couple of videos. Comment. Let's get her content out here, because it's already great. I really feel like by now she should be up there. But, you know, it was just something that she was kind of doing for fun. But she said she getting ready to make it more serious. So, y'all go support her. Dipped in Indigo, okay? So, now let's get off into this video, y'all. And this video is something that's often talked about. I'm often asked about it. I was often invited by people into this particular situation. And no, I'm not talking about polyamorous yet, but I am going to make a video out of that. In fact, me and Dipped in Indigo definitely want to collab. And since we are both off into a polyamorous lifestyle, maybe that's something we'll talk about together. But I haven't discussed that with her yet. So let me get back with her, and I'll get back with y'all about it, okay? But, okay, so besides polyamorous lifestyle and relationships, one of the most talked about, I feel like this is a little too dark, guys. My eyes looking glossy, but that's because I just got up from a nap like 20 minutes ago. Gotta drink your water. Anyways, is long distance relationships and what it takes to make them work. Now, I want to say, even just a couple of months ago, you couldn't even talk to me about a long distance relationship, to be honest with you. Like, it is not, it just wasn't my thing. It's like, I just had the spoiled brat complex about it. Like, literally, I have to see, touch, actually, like, it had to be action-based. My relationship had to be action-based because, basically, I was deeming myself as the type that, if you out of sight, boo, you out of mind, okay? So, that was my concept of long-distance relationships, but, you know, I always talk about spiritual evolution and all of that, you know, but life is just life, period. And sometimes, you know, maybe it don't even have nothing to do with spirituality. Maybe it's just that as you mature, your perception of certain things just change and shift. And that's exactly what happened for me. Like, my perception of long distance relationships and people being in love with somebody that's at a distance from them is definitely more open now than it was just a couple of months ago, years ago, because a lot of people from different states and countries have tried to, you know, get something started with me, and I've been just totally against it. Like, no, that's stupid. Like, I can't go to the movies with you. We can't be intimate with each other. Like, anyways, guys, so we about to get off into this video of the things that I feel that it takes in order to make a long distance relationship work. And you know, you can see if the person of your interest that may be at a distance, if you guys relationship possess these qualities, or if you guys individually and collectively possess these qualities that you feel will help your long distance relationship survive. But one of the definite things that's obvious and apparent is, I don't know what, is that you guys have to be deeply attracted to each other. I feel like attraction comes in many different ways because, obviously, and I've stated this in previous videos, I'm not the type of person that usually go off of physical attraction, because I've met some really shitty people that were probably the most beautiful people that I ever met on a planet, but their character did not match up to their good looks. Therefore, ergo, it didn't work out. So good looks is very minimal to me as far as going off of my physical attraction. Like, yeah, that'll get me to look at you, that'll get me to pay attention to you, but it would not sustain my attention towards you. Like, I can literally get bored with a nice looking person, especially if their spirit ain't sitting right with me, or if their character ain't sitting right with me. So when I say attraction, I mean attraction in every realm, on every dimension, whichever one is the thing that draws you in. I've stated in many videos that I'm basically a saposexual, sapiosexual, I think is how it's pronounced, or how the spelling is, sapiosexual. And basically, I'm the type of person that has to develop a mental connection with you first. After that mental connection is established, then basically my attraction for you in other places start to become relevant to me. Like, your looks, your, you know, our emotional bond, physical bond, you know. But I'm the type of person that literally starts with a mental bond. And I feel like it's been people that have been really good looking but don't have nothing to talk about. And I will absolutely not be attracted to them because my physical attraction for you can't pick up without that mental connection, if you get my drift. So that's just my example. But some people, they go off the physical. Some people, they go off of emotional, or do they feed my ego? However, whatever your love language is, you have to be attracted to that person on a whole nother level when it comes to having distance between you guys and being able to maintain a bond, or being able to maintain the interest of that person. So That's number one, which I'm not really naming them. I'm just freestyling. So I'm just going to be naming things off top. So one of the other things that I feel like you have to possess in order for a long distance relationship to kind of coast is trust. A lot of people do not have that level of trust that will be able to maintain a long distance relationship. And sometimes trust issues can be circumstantial. And sometimes people carry those trust issues from relationship to relationship, situation to situation, without there being no in between. Like, I don't care who you are. I don't trust people. People have to earn my trust instead of me giving it to them and them being able to take it away from me. So some people just don't have, just gonna have trust issues regardless of what, and they the type of person you have to prove your trustworthiness to them as opposed to prove that you're not trustworthy. So with those type of people, a long distance relationship probably will not work. Some people, they do have trust issues and they work through those issues, and they, especially like I said, if they're evolving in any kind of way, and it doesn't have to just be spiritually, it could just be that they're maturing with, you know, age or with circumstance or situations, they just become more mature, they learn a lesson, and they start to view things differently. Okay, I'm back. But basically, what was the last thing I left on? You guys have to have immense, you cannot be having trust issues. You have to have a healthy amount of trust in the person that you're interested in order to make a long distance relationship work. Okay, so that was number two. I'm going on to number three. And number three is you guys have to be on similar paths or have similar interests or both. Not being able to be present in that person's life, physically present every single day, and just y'all, like, y'all life is reduced down to like video chats, text messages, and telephone calls. Well, if you guys don't have a whole lot in common, or if you guys do not, are not on the same path, or don't possess like the majority of similar qualities, then it's gonna get boring. You're not gonna have anything to talk about if you don't have the similar interest and you're not there to be physically in each other's faces. Like, sometimes people that don't have compatible interest, if they have face-to-face relationship, they can get by on just like a physical based relationship for a while before it will start to take a toll on their relationship, because at least they have that aspect. If you don't have that at all, and all you have is basically imagination and verbal communication and just being like being able to see each other visually and virtually, then basically you'll get bored because you're not going to have enough to talk about, because y'all interests are not the same. Like, you know, they interested in one thing, you're interested in another, and y'all not there to kind of like have sex and bridge the gap. So therefore, being on a similar path, being on the same page, or having a multitude of things in common will definitely help push a long distance relationship along. This may be the last thing, but I'm not sure. And if I come up with anything else, then I'll definitely say that. But this is probably like number four. And I'm going to try to come up with five to make it at least like something, you know, like, not, I mean, I know four is an even number, but it just seems odd to kind of leave off on that. But anyways, you guys have to be respecting of each other's time and space. Like, even though you're in this relationship and it's like it you feel almost like you have to be consumed in it, and sometimes you are absolutely consumed in it, and those would be the times that I guess in person y'all would be laid up watching Netflix all day, or, you know, going from basically the bedroom to the kitchen to the bedroom to the bathroom, because y'all just in a mode of wanting to spend the whole day together. And those are the days that, you know, you're going to be consumed by telephone calls and video calls by this person, because y'all have that overwhelming urge to want to be in each other's presence, which you don't have the option to do. Therefore, y'all going to be like like caking on the phone, like caking on the video chat, like the whole day, because that would normally be a day that maybe on a Sunday where y'all would be kind of like laid up or just like locked in the house together, watching movies, caking, having sex, doing, you know, what couples do when they want to be locked in together or whatever. But there's going to be days like that, and then there's going to be days where you guys have to respect each other's space, because y'all have your own goals that y'all trying to accomplish. And 9 times out of 10, when it comes down to goals and long distance relationships, most of the time achieving those goals is what's going to be able to bring you guys closer together. Like, you got to know that having a long distance relationship is not cheap, because it's not like just gas money. It's like airfare. It's like, you know, taking a trip, being able to have time to take off of work. You know, you have to like either save your money or use a substantial amount of money and a substantial amount of time in order to visit somebody that lives in a different state or in a different country, depending on what's your long distance relationship entail, if it's different states or different countries. But different countries can be even more expensive, because it's like, if you don't already have a passport, you have to get that, and airfare is a lot more leaving the country than it is when you're just going from state to state. So, you know, it's going to be days where you guys have to focus solely on your business, and it's not like you guys are at the same house or within like a 20-30 minute drive of each other, where y'all can just be like, all right, well, you doing your work here at home, but I'm right here with you. So, you know, they may have to do work from their phone. Like, I have to work from my phone in order to promote this YouTube channel. In order for me to make these YouTube videos, I'm on my phone. And until I get other tools like a laptop camera, then that's my only option. When I'm trying to promote this page, I have to connect with other YouTubers in order to promote my YouTube page and have us support each other and build each other's likelihood up. And that kind of interferes when, if I have to talk to somebody on a regular everyday basis, or, you know, our only means of communication is over the phone, because I have to choose between work or, you know, being able to show that person some undivided attention. And sometimes I have to split it, and I have to like be on speakerphone with my love interests while I work. And, you know, that can be kind of distracting or whatever. So, you know, that's one thing. Like, sometimes you may have to go without talking to that person because you're so wrapped up in trying to get goals accomplished. But in the end goal, those goals that you have to keep in mind, that the goals that you and your person that's at a distance is trying to accomplish are more than likely things that's going to be able to bring y'all together easily and on a more regular basis before one of you decides possibly that you want to relocate and live closer to the person that you love or like love or like love and like. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. And I mean, I guess like the last thing, since I wanted to try to make it 5, would be you kind of have to have your finances together. And I feel like that kind of ties in everything else, you know, because as far as being able to, like I said, visit that person, take time away from your life, that requires for your finances to be in check. So I feel like when somebody falls in love with somebody at a distance, if they weren't financially savvy, it definitely motivates them to be. And it's a good idea to have that mindset, because you have to think about putting money up to go see that person. And, you know, it costs a little bit more to like exchange gifts with that person, because obviously you got to send it at a distance as opposed to just having it at your house waiting for when they come to visit you next. Like, here you go. Now you have to pay shipping, sending that. So, you know, trying to have your finances in check and trying to be financially responsible. That way you guys can see each other on the most possible normal basis for you guys. You know, which a normal basis for a couple that stay within minutes of each other or, you know, within an hour of each other can be, you know, 2, 3, 4 times a week or even every day sometimes. But, you know, you already know that it's going to be more like every month, every couple of months, every 6 months, depending on how far you and that love interest stay. So those are some tips and encouragement for those people that have love at a distance. Don't give up. Just be patient with your love, because eventually, especially if it's meant to be, something somehow is going to bring you guys together permanently to where all of these things are no longer an issue, because you guys will be living in the same vicinity. But until then, and while you guys are going through this dating phase, just be patient, kind, as loyal as possible, and understand that if it's true love, that it's going to work its way out, and that the gaps can always be bridged, okay? That was a tongue tire, and I'm hitting myself in the face with strings. I feel extremely, like, energetic, and I think it's because I drank coffee late today, and I had a nap, so I feel overly energetic, but that's good, because since my work schedule is kind of time-consuming throughout the week, I'm probably going to pre-record some videos for you guys, that way I can still be uploading, even though I won't be taping throughout the week. Ergo, being able to maintain my promise of being more regular. All right, guys, I think I'm right at about 20, 30 minutes, and I want to leave it at that. You guys be well. Till next time. See you, Soul Tribe.